getting started with MODIS version 6, Thermal Anomalies and Fire Data Part 1, all about accessing the data, presented by the Land Processes Distributed Active Archive Center, or LP DAAC. This video is part 1 of the Getting Started with MODIS version 6, Thermal Anomalies and Fire Data video series. This video will cover the MODIS version 6 fire products, improvements in version 6 products over version 5 products, and how to search for and download these data using the Earthdata Search Client data access tool. The LP DAAC distributes several MODIS version 6 thermal anomalies and fire products. All data distributed by the LP DAAC are available for download at no charge. The thermal anomalies and fire products identify fires and other thermal anomalies. These products provide 5-minute daily and 8-day coverage with a spatial resolution of 1 kilometer. MODIS thermal anomalies and fire products are either swath data or tiled and in sinusoidal projection. Detailed information about each of the individual products can be found on the LP DAAC website at lpdaac.usgs.gov. The MODIS data collection is reprocessed into a new version every so often to provide users with improved products. There are several improvements that were implemented in the reprocessing of the thermal anomalies and fire products. Improvements include refinements to the internal cloud mask to help distinguish between heavy smoke and clouds, fixes to prevent small forest clearings in the Amazon rainforest from generating a false flag for fire, corrections to the misidentification pixels near the scan line, improvements in detection of small fires, detection of oil rig fires near coastlines and on the ocean surface, and identification of Class 3 pixel values as non-fire water pixels instead of water. More detailed information on the changes to each of the MODIS fire data products can be found on the Digital Object Identifier, or DOI landing page on the LP DAAC website. The LP DAAC website also offers several ways to download MODIS thermal anomalies and fire products. At the bottom of the DOI landing page for each product are links to the data access tools for that specific product. In this video, step-by-step information for downloading data using NASA's Earthdata Search Client data access tool will be demonstrated. From the Earthdata Search homepage, search.earthdata.nasa.gov, click on the Earthdata login button to log in to your NASA Earthdata account. If you do not have an Earthdata account, click on the Register button and follow the prompt to create one. Now, search for the Terra MODIS version 6 8-day thermal anomalies and fire 1 kilometer level 3 gridded product, MOD14A2. Type MOD14A2 in the search bar and hit enter. Click on the MOD14A2 version 6 data product. This will pull up all of the MOD14A2 granules. Parameters for the specific time and location can be set above the map. The country of Madagascar experienced many fires in November of 2015. For this video, let's look at fire in Madagascar between November 9th and November 16th, 2015. First, pan and zoom the map to Madagascar. Change the temporal range by clicking on temporal, and then click on the start date and change the date to November 9, 2015. Now change the end date to November 16, 2015, and click on apply filter. To change the spatial information, click on spatial and select rectangle from the drop-down menu. Draw a rectangle around Madagascar. You will now see green outlines that indicate the footprints of the Terra MODIS tiles contained in your rectangle. The granules from the selected time period that are located in the selected area are now listed in the lower left-hand corner of your window. Above the granule list are options to download collection data, which allows users to download all of the matching granules, an eye icon to learn more about the data collection, a filter icon to further filter the data, and a plus sign icon, which allows users to add multiple data products to their Earthdata search project. Click on the first box in the lower left-hand corner list to select the most recent scene in the list. This box contains a preview of the granule, the Terra MODIS file name, the dates of the data, an X in the upper right-hand corner to remove the scene from your list, an I for more information, and the download icon to download a single granule. Click on the I icon to bring up the metadata for the selected granule. Remember, metadata are data about data. The metadata include the DOI, which is necessary for proper citation, as well as information on the scene's corner coordinates, input granules, and more. Click on the metadata tab for links to download metadata in different standard formats. Click on Back to Granules to return to your list. Click on Download Collection Data to download all of the granules in the list. Now review the data download order on the Data Access page. This page lists the number of granules in the order and the size of the order. From here, users can select the service options. Select Download to instantly receive the data, or select the Delivery option to receive the data via email. The Mod14A2.6 ESI service option allows the user to select various service options, including reformatting the data into a GeoTIFF or to other file formats. From here, you can also spatial subset the data, reproject the data, and subset the science datasets. Click on Submit or Continue and then Submit to submit the order. Depending on the data access method, the data will be immediately available or will be sent to the user via email. Thank you for watching our video. For more information on MODIS version 6, thermal anomalies and fire data, please visit the LP DAAC website at lpdaac.usgs.gov.